Hello, in this video, I'm going to talk about quadratic function, especially for graph, okay? Graphing for quadratic function. So if we move on to the basic quadratic function, which refer to fx equals to x to the power of 2. As you know that quadratic function is defined as, if this is a quadratic function, it will define as ax squared plus with bx plus c, where the a should not be zero, right? If a is zero, it will turn out to be a linear function, right? So a should not be zero. Then here can be zero, but a should not be zero. Then it will be a quadratic function. So this is a complete form, the general form of a quadratic function. So as we know that we need to know the basic of a the graph of quadratic function. So for example, fx equals to x squared, right? So the graph for fx equals to x squared, as you know that you can name this as y as well, right? So you are more familiar about y equals to x squared, all right? So x and y, right? So x squared, you know that the graph for x squared will be looking like this way, open upwards, right? Open upwards, or we say concave upwards. So which the graph is concave towards upwards, okay? So now, alright, for example, if I have y equals to negative x squared, right? Negative x squared will be reflected about the x-axis, right? Because it's supposed to be always positive. X squared is always above the axis, right? X-axis, because x squared at least 0. This is an important concept. The x squared at least 0. That's why your y value will be start from 0. Can you see the graph? There are no graph below the x-axis. That's why. So y, therefore y is always, x square is at least 0, because x square, anything square, it must be at least 0 or a positive number. So therefore y will be greater than equal 0. That's why you see the graph will be always on top of the x-axis. So for negative x square, for negative x squared, the graph will be opposite of this. Means that they were reflected about the x-axis because it's always negative. X squared always positive. When you multiply by negative, it will be always negative. Means below the y. The y value is always negative here, right? So it's always below the x-axis. So this is the two basic graph for y equals to x squared and y equals to negative x squared. So if you have y equals to 2x to the power of 2, let's say you have a number in front of the x squared, the shape will be still the same. The shape will be still the same, but it's steeper, sharp. So for example, y equals to this one, y equals to 2x squared. So if you have y equals to 10x squared, what's the difference? The difference is the graph is more sharp, right? Sharper, okay? Because a small x value will causing the graph to go very high value, right? Because of the 10 here, 10x squared. So means more sharper, but the shape is still the same. The constant in front here is just telling you that the graph is sharper. So for example, if you have negative 5x squared, it's the same. It will be facing downwards, but sharper compared to this, means it's something like this, sharper, okay? This is y equals to negative 5x squared. So how about if y equals to half x to the power of 2, half, or 1 over 4, it will become wider, the graph will become wider, means that wider than this, x squared, means it will open bigger, right? Bigger than this. So means it's less steeper, so it will be open bigger than this. Okay, now that is what will affect if you have the ax square here, right? In this video, I talk about the ax square. So what happened if you have a value that very big, right? It will be getting sharper. If you have a very, very small, it will be wider, okay? Okay, that's all for this video. I have many parts of video that explain about quadratic function. Hope you follow all the video about quadratic function.